In this tutorial, I want to look at and compare the sum function in SPSS with just manually adding the variables. Both of these approaches using the compute procedure. So here in this data set, we have 5 questions, which is very similar to the first tutorial I showed on how to add variables together. The only difference is now I have, notice this period here for person 9 on question 5. This indicates a missing value. So in other words, for person 9, when they completed the 5 questions, for some reason they didn't complete question number 5. Now, we don't know if they didn't complete it because they didn't like something about it or if it was simply a mistake and they just missed it. Let's go ahead and look at how to compute, how to add these variables together using 2 approaches, and we'll see if there's any difference between the 2 approaches in how they treat this missing value. So first we'll go to transform, compute variable, and I showed this in a previous tutorial, so I'm not going to go through it again except to just briefly summarize it. I have total equals Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 plus Q5. That is going to add together all of the variables. But let's actually add one thing to our total here. Let's call it total sum, indicating that we're just summing the variables together manually. Okay, we'll click OK. And then we get some output there, which we'll disregard. And there's some output from previously, which is irrelevant to what we're doing here. You notice the total sum. It added together the 5 questions, but notice what happened for person number 9. Now, it didn't add together the values. Using this approach, where the questions are just manually added together using the compute procedure, if there's a missing value anywhere among the 5 questions, then SPSS simply puts a missing value in the place of the total. Okay, now I want to show you another approach using the compute procedure. So we'll go back to transform and then compute variable. And now what I want to do is use a function. Okay, so now we're going to call this total sum function. I'll just call it sum f for function. And here I need to delete this area, so highlight it and press delete. And then we're going to go to the function group. Notice if you scroll down, you will see statistical. Double click on that, and then it brings up down below a number of different functions that are available. And we want to use the sum function. That's going to add up all the values, and there's a description in the box here that you can read. Okay, so we want the sum function, so I'm going to double click that. And notice what it does. It puts in here sum question mark comma question mark. Now we need to fill or replace the question marks with our variables. So we have Q1 here, and then we have Q2, and the format is you put the variable and then a comma, and then the next variable, and so on. So Q3, comma, Q4, comma, Q4, comma, Q5. Okay, so we have sum, Q1, comma, etc., all the way through Q5.